There are more lost people in the world this morning than ever there have been in history, and the Church of Jesus Christ is responsible for that. I'm sick to death of mediocrity. Come on, preachers, how many of us will be clear from the blood of the people in our streets? Every one of us know to live better than we're living, and that's our condemnation. If I were a Protestant Pope, I'd close every church in the nation for a month. There wouldn't be another word of preaching. Your people can't handle the light they have now at the judgment seat. And all you'll do on Sunday is add condemnation to them. And revival only comes by birth. There's only one proof of the Holy Ghost in your life, and that's a holy life. Why is there no movement of God today as in former days? This country has had some of the greatest revivals in history because it's had some of the greatest praying men in history. Why should the world take us seriously when we don't take God seriously? Come on! I said to you and say to you again, whether you're a pastor or what, the only reason you don't have revival in your church is you're willing to live without it. Christianity has not been weighed in the balances and found wanting. It's been tried, found difficult, and rejected. You see, there is no way to get... You can't organize revival. You can't say revival will be born there, for if you do, it'll be born there. You can't say that the man is the revivalist because he'll come from here.
There can be no revival again, I say, without travail.
We want birth without pregnancy. We want birth without pain. There is no revival that's ever been in history that isn't preceded by travail.
As I said, there's two great reasons we don't have revival. One, we're content to live without it. Number two, it's too costly. We don't want God to disrupt our status quo.
You know, the hindrances to revival, the greatest hindrance to revival made in America is evangelism.
When are we going to get serious about being serious about revival? We're not serious about it.
Evangelism has to be organized. Revival cannot be organized.
Okay, we're looking, I say again with all my heart, we're looking for a painless Pentecost. There's no part-time service. Leave all and follow me.
Prayers don't move God because they don't move us. If they don't move us, they never move God.
If a thing doesn't burn in me, why in God's name should it burn in you? Our pulpits are full of dead men preaching dead sermons to dead people.
When were you last in a prayer meeting that was bathed with tears, or somebody got angry over the monopoly of the devil in the world?
You know, if we'd spend as much time teaching people to pray as we taught the choir, we'd have set the world on fire. The Christian life can only be lived one way, and that's God's way.
We pray for your holy name's sake that you will invade this sanctuary tonight. We pray you'll work spiritual revolutions in us. We pray that some of us may go to our own funeral tonight and die to self and end all the failure and all the weakness.
The sky has no power. Our word is so empty, ritualistic, so formalistic, so neat. Lord, we pray soon you'll burst the wineskins.
Peeps out to a door without ceasing. Lord, I pray with all my heart that nobody in this room, even that precious babe, our dear sister has, if Jesus has, but not one of us will die immature. Lord, don't let us step out of line with the will of God. Because he that doeth the will of God abideth forever. You didn't say he who has the best theology. You didn't say he who has the biggest ministry. You said he that doeth the will of God Lord, we think of these heroes in Hebrews 11. They did the will of God in their day. We want to do the will of God in our day.
Find help. And Lord, we need help. Our need is so great individually. We need a vision. We need a faith. We need of love. We need of courage. We need of compassion for a broken, lost, damned world around us. A world without God and without hope. Lord, we know every human system is bankrupt. We've tried them over and over and over again. We think of Hitler who's going to change the world, and Stalin who's going to change the world, and Mussolini.
Don't point the finger, God, I beg you. Don't have to point the finger at me and say, Rednil, I wanted to tell you many things in Texas, but you couldn't bear them. You weren't big enough to share my secrets. You weren't big enough to share my grief. You weren't big enough to share my revelation. God put us striding in us beyond anything you'd ever known.
The power. Where is the Pentecost of glory? Where is the revelation? Where is the prophetic word? Can't truthfully sing like a mighty army moves the church of God. It's not true.
Let the things of earth grow strangely dim. They look strangely grim when we get into eternity.
But as I read today, there are supposed to be 36 million people around the world filled with the Holy Ghost, and yet only 120 turned a nation upside down. And before very long, people said, these men who have turned the world upside down have come here also. God, God, heal us of our impotence. Lord, we're convinced there are more lost people in the world at this moment than ever in history. Dear God, we pray for our young people. They've never seen the glory of God. They sit through a service and answer some little questions sometimes, but they've never gone out of the sanctuary staggering under the revelation of God. Staggering under the majesty of God. If we had 1,000 tongues, they wouldn't be enough. If we had 1,000 vocabularies, if we could be crucified ourselves 1,000 times over, it would not be a payment of love for all you've done for us. Lord, we ask you to get us from the very soles of our feet to the crowns of our heads vibrating with God, with the love of God and the power of God and the grace of God. Do this now, Lord. As we open this book, open our hearts, open our understanding. And let this faith we've spoken of kindled in us tonight. Lord, I think of Wesley's cry, so 200 years ago, and you did it, when he cried, give me the faith which can remove and sink the mountain to a plain. Give me that childlike praying love which longs to build thy house again. Thy love let it my heart o'erpower and all my simple soul devour. Enlarge, inflame, and fill my heart with boundless charity divine. So shall I all my strength exert and love them with a zeal like thine, and turn them to a pardoning God, and quench their brands in Jesus' blood. No wonder he added, O Jesus, Jesus, dearest Lord, forgive me if I say for very love thy sacred name 1,000 times a day. Lord, if you were to stop 1,000 times a day, it would not be enough. There's more in our hearts than we can give expression to in vocabulary. We want to hear. Not only hear, hearken, and obey, and do the will of God. Because your word says, he that doeth the will of God abideth forever.
Change our desires. Change our aspirations. Make us captives. As an old saint said in England years ago, make me a captive, Lord, and then I shall be free. Force me to render up my sword, and I shall conqueror be. I sink in life's alarms when by myself I stand. Imprison me within thine arms, and strong shall be my hand. Oh God, we bless you that you're more adequate than we can ever dream of. I think, Lord, when we get to eternity, some of us have lived many years, but if you were to cut us all off tonight and sweep us into eternity, we'd discover that we're only in spiritual water to our ankles. Not to our knees, not to our loins. We're still paddling on the edge of the ocean of the possibilities of grace.